Hello and welcome to the Sweet 16 of the NCAA 2020 virtual basketball tournament for men. Enjoy.
Welcome to Sweet 16 coverage of the NCAA tournament on CBS Sports. Today's game is between the NC State Wolfpack and the Louisville Cardinals. And of course, Bill, our starting five.
These guys are expected by the team to set the tone, Gus. It's an honor to be a starter. It's very important that when given the opportunity, you do what's asked of you.
And just before things get underway, let's look at what each of these teams is going to be paying extra attention to. And after all that anticipation, we're underway. On the outside. Decision there. The Wolfpack's in a hurry. The Wolfpack set up for a round one.
That's tough because guys can make shots and yet they can penetrate and kick.
Sutton receives the ball. Both teams are looking to get something going here. They work the perimeter. Ten on the shot clock. Want to thank you for joining us tonight. I'm Gus Johnson, and joining me, the man with all of the insight, the governor, Bill Rafter. A great trap initiated by the defense. Down in the low block. This is what I call home court advantage. Crowd is on their feet. Tough place to play. Way out on the right wing. And he can't get the bounce. Snatches the board. Daniels handles the feed. Fired. He missed it.
Oh, physicality.
Williamson receives the pass. Around 8 minutes remaining on the game clock. Nice pass to the low block. In the lane.
Squared up on the catch. Got his puppies in order.
The Cardinals seem like they want to take the defensive pressure to the next level.
Watch for some full court pressure, Gus. I'm curious to see how the pressure will be handled.
Out on the right wing. Turnover, they'll go the other way. On the baseline. Out of bounds and a change of possession. Had a great release on this three ball.
How about that? Defense relaxed. He's able to convert deep.
Great defense.
In the right spot.
Jams it. We are at the 7-minute mark. On the left side. Shot clock shows 10. Feed the low post. In the lane. Shots off. They work the perimeter. Shots up. No. Pulls down the rebound. Daniels handles the pass. We are at the 6-minute mark. The sophomore. The Cardinals have controlled the tempo here.
Gotta love the way they've come out here and really focused on their game plan. They've done a good job making sure the game is being played at their pace.
Off the mark. Rebound. Down the lane. Finger roll. So easy for this game. You've got to be prepared when you go up against this team, Raph. Their pressure can be relentless at times. They love to pressure you full court.
Well, you're right on top of that, Gus. They really like to force you into mistakes with their pressure.
Looking for a good shot. He got it up and in. They've worked the perimeter. Foul on the play. Once again, a case of being too aggressive defensively.
There's nothing wrong with being aggressive, but you just gotta know when to back off.
Raph, these two teams in the first half of this tournament game have shown that they definitely belong. It's obvious to me that neither one is ready to go home.
Both teams are competing well right now. The goal at this point in the game is to remain close. You don't want to fall too far behind. These teams are demonstrating that this one may go down to the wire.
He got them both. The Cardinals look like they want to use their defense to speed up the tempo in this game.
While pressuring in the full court is a great tactic if you have the personnel first. Otherwise, it's an ill-advised play on the defensive end. You've got to know your strengths and stick to them.
On the inside. He can't get it to go.
Push it!
The Cardinals are really controlling the tempo.
Doing a nice job of controlling the speed of the game, Gus. They're really dialed in here, and coach has got to enjoy it.
And he can't get the bounce. Looking for a good shot. Jump shot. He missed it.
Get out and fill.
Both teams looking to get in a bit of a rhythm here. On the outside. We're at the 4-minute mark. Receives the pass in the paint.
How about that elevation?
He can put up points and he can move the ball.
You know he's a real talent. He can set up his teammates for open looks and really has a nose for the goal.
The Cardinals seem like they want to take the defensive pressure to the next level.
Watch for some full court pressure, Gus. I'm curious to see how the pressure will be handled.
Once again, a case of being too aggressive defensively.
There's nothing wrong with being aggressive, but you just gotta know when to back off.
At the foul line.
Solid shooter.
Makes it. Hits two at the charity stripe. The Cardinals are looking to force the tempo now by extending their defense.
Well, Gus, forcing the opposition to play 94 feet is ideal. if they can't play the full court game.
Looking for a good shot. First team foul. Aggressive on defense here, and he winds up with the ball.
You always get your hand reaching in, you get in trouble.
Allen, now in his second year with the team.
He's still young, but the coach has him out there for a reason. He tends to make the right decisions out there, which means more playing time for him. A simple concept that applies to everyone, regardless of age or experience.
Makes the shot. May be in some trouble. The ball stripped. Takes it.
Look at that block. Terrific.
Out of bounds, and we're not going anywhere. The Cardinals have come out here and are really focused on moving the ball and playing pretty together.
If you're on the floor, that means your coach believes that you can make a contribution. This team has received quality play from many different individuals.
On the outside. We're at the 3-minute mark. Stolen. Now in transition. Good job defensively. On the left side. Fires. Shots off.
Great strength.
The Cardinals running their zone offense.
Now this particular offense is extremely tough because they get into the high-low look.
They work the perimeter. Inside. 2 minutes left on the game clock. The Cardinals now running the four around one.
Must be alert on that defensive end because guys get pinned and they can step out and knock down the deep one.
In the post. In the lane. No.
Way to get up, big fella!
Out on the left wing. Jump shot and answer. Dribbles around the trap.
What a great job of beating their trap, Gus.
In the paint. Shots off.
He owns the window.
Under 1 minute remaining on the game clock. Way out on the right wing. And he's there with the power jam. Strips the ball. Now looking to attack. Ooh, athlete. We've got a break in the action, folks. Stay tuned for more CBS Sports coverage of NCAA basketball. Timeout call. We'll get you back into the action right after this. And after the timeout, we're all set to pick things up. Dials up a long-range shot. And no!
Oh, physical play.
Off the mark.
What a coach will be happy with that.
Shots off. With the first half in the books, we're now ready for the road to the Final Four. Stay tuned. And a look at our game summary will give you an idea of how these two teams are stacking up against one another so far. Let's check in and take a look at how both sides are doing with the keys to the game. Bill, what's going through these young guys' minds now? Here they are. They've worked all season long just to get to the NCAA tournament, and we've got a half behind us and a half to go, and somebody's got to go.
You know what I think is really impressive here tonight, Gus? Is the fact that both of these clubs are focused on each possession. A level of concentration is where you'd expect it to be during the tournament.
Now with 10 to shoot. In the lane. Gets it to go. Johnson handles the feed. He shoots from the top of the circle, but he misses his target.
One shot, Gus. You always want to limit the opposition to one opportunity.
Call for the foul. The Cardinals have come out here and are really focused on moving the ball and playing gritty together.
They're really making it tough on the opposition. The defense is going to have to make some adjustments to counter this multi-headed offensive attack.
He throws up the shot. No. Perry receives the ball. He lets it go. He misses from long range. In the post. Fires. He can't get the bucket to fall. Perry gets the ball. Shots up. And misses. Can finish. This guy is really known as a power guy.
When he gets it that deep and low in the box, there's not much you can do. Say goodnight.
Daniels handles the feed. Can't get it to go. Perry receives the ball. Jump shot.
Big time dagger.
The Cardinals are really looking to turn up the pressure and perhaps tempo with this press build.
It looks like they want the tempo to be faster. This change will likely increase the pace of play.
Comes up empty. Sutton with the ball. He lets it go. And he can't hit the shot. Daniels takes the feed. in the lane. He can't get it to go.
Rebound and run.
On the left side. Shots off.
Makes them so competitive on the glass.
On the left side. Second team foul. Too aggressive on defense here. He winds up with the ball.
Well, you always get your hand reaching in, you get in trouble.
With the free throw.
They can set up the press.
Gets it. Makes the shot. May have him right where they want him, Raph. Out on the right wing. We are at the 6 minute mark. And he can't get the bounce. They get the offensive rebound and put back.
Once again, nobody checked out. That coach is going to be beside himself.
Daniels handles the pass. The Cardinals are looking to force the tempo now by extending their defense.
Gus, forcing the opposition to play 94 feet is ideal if they can't play the full court game.
Raph, it's obvious that the tournament is very competitive this year. These two teams have shown that they belong. They played great in the first half, and now it's likely that this contest will go down to the wire.
God, this is a close one, Gus. I think the last few possessions are going to dictate who moves on and who goes home.
Bates gets the ball.
Fired. How about this kid, huh?
The Cardinals are doing a great job of controlling the pace of this game.
I'll tell you, if you make the opposition play at your pace, it can really get them out of their comfort zone.
Johnson takes the pass. He shoots from the deep corner. No!
Get out and fill.
We're at the 5 minute mark. Way out on the right wing. He unloads the three.
How about that, Gus?
Tump it inside. Jump shot. No!
Great job of checking out, securing the rebound there. Limiting the opposition to one shot.
Daniel gets the pass. That's charging.
A classic case of a player trying to do too much, Gus. He forced the issue there.
The Wolfpacks are firing on all cylinders right now.
It's great when you're playing together, and sometimes that's easier said than done. They're making the right reads at this very moment.
Johnson handles the feed. Fires. He nails the bucket. We're at the 4 minute mark. The Cardinals are looking to force the tempo now by extending their defense.
Gus, forcing the opposition to play 94 feet is ideal. They can't play the full court game.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Looking for the bomb. It's no good. looking for a good shot. Now we've got a turnover. Out on the wing. He launches the bomb. Misses from the outside. 3 minutes left on the game clock. Well, Raph, this could go down to the wire.
You've got to love these close ones, Gus. Every error is magnified and could be the difference between a win or a loss. Gus, you've got to love these tight ones. So much on the line here. One wrong move is all it takes. There's no room for error.
On the outside. Jump shot. It won't fall. Daniel receives the ball. Rejected out of there. Call for the foul. Obviously too aggressive here defensively.
You really got to know your limitations, Gus. With him in their lineup, they've got someone who's been there before, and he has the experience to get through some tough situations. That experience on your roster will help many coaches sleep at night.
He takes it away. They would like to get it inside to the low block. And he misses the shot. He gets the shot to fall. The Cardinals are taking things to the next level with their extended pressure defense, Raph.
An aggressive move on their part, Gus. They'll be looking to force some turnovers.
He comes away with it. Looking for a good shot. Fires. The shot won't fall. The Cardinals look like they want to use their defense to speed up the tempo in this game.
Well, pressuring in the full court is a great tactic if you have the personnel, Gus. Otherwise, it's an ill-advised play on the defensive end. You've got to know your strengths and stick to them.
Out on the left wing. He shoots from the top of the circle. On the right side. Jump shot. He drains the bucket. The Cardinals are looking to force the tempo now by extending their defense.
Well, Gus, forcing the opposition to play 94 feet is ideal if they can't play the full court game.
Let's get another look at the layup.
You've got to make these inside ones, Gus. They're high percentage shots. They just got to be completed.
They set it up from the baseline. Turnover. They'll go the other way.
A little clock management now, Gus. They have to foul in order to stop the clock. Gus, I think they'll keep fouling until they're back into this game.
Foul. And that stops the clock again. And I think that's his disqualifying foul. And yet another stoppage and yet another foul.
And why not?
And, of course, another foul as they try to remain close.
Not much else they can do.
To the line. It's good! Makes it! Timeout on the floor. CBS Sports coverage of NCAA basketball will continue after this. And we're ready. And we're back. Gus Johnson along with Bill Raftery with you here, ready to inbound after the timeout. Great block shot. Ball's going to stay down here. This one's coming in from the baseline. The Wolfpack's now running a zone offense.
The impact very similar to their man-to-man. They find the open guy.
And the foul will stop the clock momentarily. A chance for one and the bonus. Got it! And we're back, ready to get things going again after the timeout. Long down court pass. He shoots from the right of the circle. Shots off.
Look to outlet.
Coach, I think we saw a pretty good tournament game. Both teams competed hard. But that's the end of the season for one of these teams.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all of the little intangibles we consistently talk about. And that was the difference in this game.
That does it for us here today. Until next time, for Coach Raftery, I'm Gus Johnson. Thanks for watching College Basketball here on CBS Sports.